Hi, welcome to VC Circle. I have with me today Manak and Roman, who are the co-founders of Notesgen. So Manak, tell me, how did you build Notesgen and what are you really trying to build at Notesgen?
So Notesgen was launched in 2015. Sure. And what we are trying to solve is the content discovery problem for students. What we have done it is by, firstly, we've created a global community of more than 600,000 users from 130 plus countries. Sure. We have brought them together. We have connected them, most relevant students, with each other. We've ensured that we've given them the platform where they can publish their own content for free or price, whatever they find fit. They can they price it, they can earn money from them. And it's basically giving the power to the students, giving them the accessibility of content which they keep running around and asking from their peers. So we've taken the entire peer-to-peer four wall closed room concept to a global level. Okay. So that a student has the ability to buy notes from someone sitting in India or someone sitting in Zimbabwe, Pakistan, US, African nations, anywhere in the world.
How is it relevant for someone in India and how is it relevant for someone in Zimbabwe?
We ask students to upload notes based on topics.
Okay.
So topic, when we talk about topics, it becomes relevant to all the students all across the world, because the fundamentals of all these subjects, you know, syllabus can change across universities, but the topics, but the most you know, basic topic would remain the same.
At a very micro level.
We operate at the most
micro level.
And yeah, then it becomes relevant to students all across the world.
Sure.
Because for example, Newton's first law of motion, it is taught in US as well, and the same Newton's first law of motion is taught in India as well. So if I'm talking about a conceptual level, the concept remains the same, whether I'm talking a student from India or from US.
You spoke about building a community.
Yeah.
So tell me, Notesgen is available in how many countries?
We are present in 130 odd countries. By present meaning, we have users, incoming users from
130 countries.
That many countries.
Which are the top countries?
The top country being India, obviously, then we have US, and we have neighboring countries as well, you know, South Asian countries from where we are getting decent amount of traction. In terms of usage, we have around 100,000 users who are coming onto the platform every month.
Okay.
Out of that 100,000, almost 20 to 25,000 users are new users who are coming onto the platform every month. Yeah, and we have around 70 to 75% repeat visitors who are coming, you know, purchasing content, accessing the content that they have purchased and uploading content.
And if I may add, we have, you asked about how students are consuming content from outside countries.
Sure.
We have students from Africa, African countries are consuming maths and science from American and Australians.
Sure.
And we have Russians also. Who are consuming content which has been uploaded by students from not only India, but from other countries as well.
So, but how do you guys make money? You take a cut on every download?
Yeah,
we have a revenue model in place where we take a percentage of the sales that happen on the platform. Apart from that, we are currently, we have partnered with CL, Career Launcher, for, you know, we have had two levels of partnership with Career Launcher. First is the revenue sharing model in which the sales on the content that is being sold, Career Launcher's content, will get a cut out of it. And the second model being that we have partnered with CL for to become a reader platform, content reader platform for CL students, so that they can access their course content on our platform. So we, you know, in a way, and we are in talks with a lot of other enterprise education businesses as well on the same lines. So we want to become a de facto platform for accessing content online and offline.
You started in 2015.
Yeah.
So it has been 2 years.
Yes.
So have you also raised some funding?
We raised our first funding in back in January 2015.
Okay.
Which it was through a Angel Network Connect we had. Individuals participated in the round.
Sure.
And next one was in the 2016 itself. It was more family and friends oriented.
Sure. So what is Notesgen's game plan for 2017? I think it will be a crucial year because you've grown to such a user base and you like to convert them to good money. And so what's your game plan for 2017?
You know, the first biggest game plan for us is, yes, we want to partner with, so the pivot that we have done, a small pivot in the B2C sector that we have done, we'd like to partner with as many as people, clients that we can, so that our focus on sustainability remains. Because, you know, if the company is making money, it's good for the company, right? On the products end, yes, we are going to introduce other modes of communication, interaction, audio, video, etc., where Roman can throw light a little more.
Yeah, we have till now we supported only PDF format in terms of when we talk about being a content platform, we have supported only PDF, but we are looking at podcasts, we are looking at videos.
Bigger picture of this entire product will always remain peer-to-peer. That's the bigger vision, but this small pivot in the B2C sector that we have done, we want to ensure that good quality branded content reaches everyone, mm-hmm. so that the customer trust is built. And eventually, we talked about 2017, we also have in mind that we successfully go ahead and raise the next institutional funding. But before that, yes, we have a lot of things to execute and prove to the world that this is the go-to platform.
Thank you. Thanks a lot for talking.
Yeah. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Stay tuned for more.